But up first, it's the 3-seeded 7-12, 5-2 in conference Monmouth Hawks, meeting the 12-5, 6-1 second-seeded St. Francis Red Flash.
Recorded a shutout in the semifinals a year ago. It skips off Makia's stick, but she gets it right back. Loose in front, and it goes in the goal! Off the penalty corner, the Red Flash strike first. And with 20:35 to play in the first half, it's 1-0 St. Francis. Here's O'Dwyer sending it in. Back to the top, Mackin settles it down, passes off to Carroll. Carroll sends it in on goal and will go wide of the cage. Monmouth with the insertion, top of the circle, passing off to Mackin. Mackin trying for a lane and they score! And the Monmouth Hawks get the equalizer with 15:39 to play in the first half. O'Dwyer didn't quite get enough mustard on it. They'll bring it back out to the perimeter, sent it on the ground, out in front, and Monmouth able to score. And now coming from behind Snyder to start it back up. Ball is loose in front. Matthews goes down, and the ball is cleared to the near sideline. Sent in on the ground, loose in the circle. Vitale there on the denial. The goal, trying to get some shots off, looking maybe for a deflection. Shot saved by Matthews, she gets down, ball loose in front. Well, the third time wasn't the charm. Monmouth lost to Ryder 2-1 in the final last year. But for the fourth straight season, it's gonna be a return trip to the championship game for the Monmouth Hawks, as they knock out the St. Francis Red Flash 3-1 here in the 2012 field hockey semifinals. Moses is standing by with the Snyders of Hanover player of the game.
Well, Michelle, a great win for you guys today. You'll be in the conference championship game for the fourth consecutive year. Talk about your team's win today.
We really just played together, and I mean, we had really good passes and we connected really well. With the turf being a little different than what we're used to, we did really well.
Well, you had a goal right before halftime. Take us through that play and how that went for you.
I don't really remember, but I just hit it and it went in, so I don't really remember what happened.
Well, more than anything else, it established some great momentum for your team going into halftime. Talk about what halftime was like for your team.
We just talked about the things that we needed to do in the next half, the things that we were struggling with, and we capitalized on them, and we did really well in the second half.
Joined now by Coach, a great win for your team. You'll be in the conference championship for the fourth consecutive year. Where did this game turn for you in the first half?
Definitely after the first 10 minutes, and we really worked on holding possession, like I said, at halftime. Just, you could see towards the end of the game, the like frantic pace that picks up, and we've working on all season and trying to just calm down, keep possession, keep moving the ball around instead of just trying to hit the ball up the field.
I thought your defense played very well in the second half. Who was the star there?
They all just played phenomenal. They really, really stepped it up. I thought Nicole Manzano had a fantastic game. Alex Carroll, Allie, and our little freshman over in the left side, Lauren, they all just did fantastic. And our keeper made some really key saves.
Well, when you look ahead to tomorrow, what's something that you're going to look for differently from your team?
I think we just, the second half, we got a little bit sloppy, and just to kind of put those two halves together is going to be really important. We got our goals in the first half, and we'd like to get some more in the second half, too, just to ensure, you know, championship game, every goal is going to count.
Well, Coach, thanks for your time. We'll see you tomorrow.
Thanks.